Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty speaking from Naio Nails. In this video, we have the fabulous Fay.
Who's paying no attention because she's on her phone.
Right, okay. So Fay's turned up and look what she's done. How did you do it? Explain to us how you did this.
It was split both sides. She's got splits on both sides.
Now you see how long these are. You know Fay always has like really long nails. Now, the nail is too long for Fay's nails. She is fully aware of this. She's fully aware that there could be problems with maintaining that length. And because her nail bed is a lot shorter than we would like it, it creates her a bit of a problem. Don't get me wrong, she very rarely breaks them, to be honest with you. But she knows that, you know, she can't
she
be...
She puts a lot of pressure on it, don't
she? Yeah, she can't be using them as tools and things like that.
To be honest, they look actually quite short for you.
We did have a fresh set.
We did have them. Yeah, we did have them.
Were we a four and a half? Or four?
I think we might have gone three and a half.
We did not.
We did, I promise.
No.
Get your sculpt on for me,
Nana.
She says it like I'm joking. I'm not joking. We definitely did a three and a half. If it's a four, it's because you've just done whatever you feel like. The story of Kirsty is alright. They do look good though, considering that's got 4 weeks. They've been Barcelona.
They've been Barcelona?
They've been Barcelona.
Did they have a good time?
They went to Barcelona, they had a great time.
Did you go?
Got up to lots of naughty things.
Did you?
Right. Now you tell me what that is.
Ooh.
Okay, so we went to a three. So because you can see that she needs a fill, yeah? Don't look at my nails. Well, this one's quite nice, but this one, however, has metallic all down it and everywhere because I might have got a bit all over me.
Anyway.
Well, we kind of do need to see our nails.
Kirsty's on mine.
Kirsty's?
No.
Right, so let me tell you about Fay's nails. How many weeks?
Four.
4 weeks these have been on. Four. And what happens when they grow is this gap is here at the back. So the stress area, which is, you know, the apex, it's giving it that strength, grows forward and it kind of acts like a bit of a seesaw and it will pop off at the back. You have a little bit of lifting on that one, can you see? Just there, a little tiny bit there. So that's because of this pressure and it acting like a seesaw.
Does it hurt when she presses down there?
No, not at all. No.
Because it looks like it should.
No.
So what we're going to do today is fill Fay's nails. And we'll talk through how we do this process. So Fay has unicorns, look at that. We did a video on this. I loved it that much that I had to do a video on it.
Somebody stole your design.
Oh, that's not good.
Oh yeah, sorry. Stole you, somebody else is walking around with your nail on. I'm joking. We did it on a tip, didn't we?
Yeah.
We did it on a tip, so nobody else got it. It's in the tip bag.
You can smash it.
It's in the bag of tips. No, she can't. So we'll fill these. I'm going to show you how to remove the stones because this unicorn is difficult to remove. We're going to use my super duper amazing, brought to me by Fay herself, and they are the best. What are these for again?
Podiatry.
So what we're going to do is basically grab the sides of the stones, and what we'll do is crack the actual gel. So it's come round here. Being quite gentle, just basically putting a bit of firm pressure and pin. You can do this with normal cuticle nippers as well. An old pair are better.
It's
support the nail. You've got to support the nail. You don't want to cause any lifting or any trauma to the nail. So with this one's built up quite high. Fay loves these when we build them up really high like this. You're going to do the same thing, but be wary of where this is going to fling to. So you need to just watch your eyes. You could wear safety goggles. Right, so now we're going to use my e-file to remove any bulk. So I'm removing bulk and I'm also whipping over the top of the nail to take off that top coat. Keep moving your e-file all the time because you don't want to stay in one spot too long because you will have a bit of heat. Now I'm going to push back the cuticles with my metal cuticle pusher. I'm going to get rid of any excess cuticle. So I'm going to do that on all of these. I'm going to use my e-file on a slow rotation. So this is on 5. On a 9, I wouldn't go any higher than 10, and I'm just basically exfoliating any of that dead skin off the nail plate, and that'll help to prevent any lifting. You don't want the acrylic to lift off the back, and obviously we have to really take time and care when we do this on Fay because she's a fussy woman.
You only want to see her once a month.
Yeah, I don't want them popping off. Seeing her once a month is enough.
Oh, fair.
I love her. Just couldn't live with her. So now I'm going to blend this a little bit more and also whip over the natural nail, which will abrase it and make the acrylic stick to it. So we remove any shine off that nail. So I'm going to wipe over with acetone. I've done quite a bit of filing. I want to get rid of any dust. So I'm going to make it nice and clean like that. Yep. I'm going to do that on all of them. Right, I'm going to use the nail prep dehydrator to dehydrate that back part of the nail, just on the natural nail. I'm going to do that on all of the nails. And then we are going to put on the acid-based primer. Let that disperse over the nail. Took a lot off this one because it does need quite a lot of rebalancing. I'm going to use max adhesion because it's so hot in here.
You can't use high speed.
I can't use high speed. I'd normally use high speed for fills, but we need to really slow this down. So we're going to use max adhesion. And I have caramel dream.
Could you use cold monomer?
You can put your monomer in the fridge and you can also put it in a jar that's got water and ice in it. Mm-hmm. Now, if anybody's used caramel dream before, this sets up like that anyway. So, being so hot as well. In this room because we
clearly hot stuff.
Well, yeah, we've got to be careful. So what I'm looking for when I'm doing a maintenance on this is I'm rebalancing the apex making sure the sides have enough, making sure there's no hairline cracks. If there is, you've got to repair them while you are adding the product in. Fay likes a really high apex. So we're going to make sure we put that in. Going to add a little bit of true pink to bring this height up without colour. I'm going to fill the nails that have got the nude colours first of all, and then I'll get my colours out for the one with the glitter in, and then at least when I work I won't have contaminated liquid with a bit of glitter in. If I do the glitter now and then try to do this nude colour at the back, the possibilities of me having a bit of glittering aren't great. The longer the nail, the bigger the apex needs to be, and you're putting that apex back into the place it should be, which is in the back third here. So we've got all the colours. We have all of these colours. I don't think anybody expected anything less, to be honest. This is fake after all. I'm not sure that one's even in it now.
How many have we got?
No, it has. Luke. Blue. It's there. It's trickled.
Yeah,
through.
It is.
Yeah, trickled. But there's three blues.
Yeah, it has. You know it is as well. I'm not even joking, am I? You know you've put it in.
Right, so let's crack them all open.
Okay, so anybody who wants to know all the colours, take a screenshot now.
So these two with the colours, we are going to put the colours back in. So I'm going to put a clear bead of acrylic, very thinly, just there, and I'm going to touch. I put that thin layer on to help with adhesion. If you over pack the glitter onto the natural nail, it won't adhere as good. Pick up a little bit of mylar. Put the clear on top of that to encapsulate. So we're encapsulating the glitter and the mylar, but we're also rebalancing the nail. So we're going to make sure the apex is in the right place. Because it's grown, it's going to have moved forward, so we need to put it back where it belongs. Again, a little bit of the...
I woke up this morning. I'd been dreaming that I'd only got 3 nails on the out of 10 nails, I'd only got 3 nails on, and all I was thinking is, I've got to go work all day. Won't be leaving work till like 3, and I'm going to need like 7 brand new nails on. I woke up. That's obviously because I've got anxiety about having one lost, one missing. I'm not even joking. And someone even asked me in my dream, and I don't know who it is because I'd have chinned them. Somebody asked me in my dream, why have you only got 3 nails on?
Did you wake up like that?
Yeah. But it happens, you know, that does. And I think it's because I've got, like, separation anxiety from having a messy nail. Do you?
You've got separation anxiety.
I think if I've got a nail missing, I genuinely fret about it. I mean, I fret about most things, but...
So we're going to file this nail in the normal filing routine. So side walls first. Cuticle area. And contour the top surface. I am really hot. Like, I can't believe, I didn't think I've ever actually sweated this much in all my life. I'm going to wipe over with acetone now. I'll just smooth that nail. Smooth them all down. On this nail, we are going to use Eclipse, which is from the Aurora collection. And I want it quite thin on the end, just want that little bit of glitter, so I'm really going to drag that. So you can still see the mylar shining through. Put me on the lamp. I'm going to use these colours now. So we've got Voila, Rich Teal, and Forbidden Garden from the Platinum Collection. And a Pearly Collection we have. Gorgeous Orange.
So you're going marbly then?
Sort of a bit like. Just keep them together. Not, I don't want to marble it too much because I want to see the colours. I don't want to see it too. Do you know what I mean? You don't want to marble it. You want me to marble
it. Never do what I want. No, don't get short tempered with me. My face.
I'm not marbling it as such, I'm just messing up those harsh edges, running the dotting tool backwards and forward through the polish. While I'm doing that, I'm making sure it's going right to each side, so it's going side to side. Now I'm going to put base coat over the top of this, and I bet you're thinking, well, why? Why are you doing that? I'll tell you why. We are going to use the Urban Graffiti Aqua Gel. This is going to be the base. It will make everything adhere really well. Put me that into the lamp. We're going to use It's Clear Dear from the Urban Graffiti Acro Gel.
You can't say that without saying it how it's supposed to be said.
What?
It's clear, dear.
It's clear, dear. I need a bit more than that, actually.
It's like saying, I'll be back. Always have to say it as Arnie.
I know, but it's clear, dear. I don't know why it's off.
I don't either, but it just sounds like that's how you've got to say it.
I thought you knew why it was off then.
No.
Right, so we can scrape that on. So we can move this around where we want. You just want to damp your brush down with...
Oh my God, I wasn't expecting to come out of that.
Are you? So damp your brush down with the gel residue wipe-off solution, and we're going to spread this product out all over the neck. So I've spread that over nice and thin. What we're going to do now is apply straight over the top of that the Urban Graffiti top coat. So you're not going to cure that. We're going to put the Urban Graffiti top coat directly over the top.
Faye is so confused right now. She's never seen this before.
What is going on?
You're like, what? I've never seen it before. This can't work.
No, it can't.
You're like, what are you going to do now? Just cure it? No, no. Maybe everybody at home is thinking the same thing when they're watching it on the phone.
These acrogels are interesting. I'm intrigued.
Mm. Now, we're going to get the tiny little crystals. And we're going to sprinkle. All over the nail. You better put in too much on and too little. Turn that to the side. And you can see the colour of the gel polish coming through underneath. Just tap that finger, knock off any excess. You want a clean brush.
I'm absolutely mesmerised.
And you're going to just pat on the top and make sure they sit as flat as you can get them. So what they're doing is sitting inside the acrogel. So once you're happy that they're all secure.
So never.
If you're happy and you know, you clap your hands.
No, don't, not until she's cured it.
Yeah.
Where they all go blasting off everywhere.
Yeah. We can now pop that into the lamp. What I'm going to do now is use the Urban Graffiti top coat and just seal the free edge. Plan. I'm going to put this Aurora Polarize. Right, I'm going to finish off with some pink pineapple cuticle oil. This girl loves a bit of glitter, don't you, Fay?
No.
Bit of sparkle.
No.
Hate it, don't you?
Hate it.
Oh, I love them. There you go, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video with the fantastic Fay and obviously cameraman Adam.
Can you try and say Fay with a little bit more? With the fantastic Fay.
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 Oh, with the wonderful, absolutely sugar-coated Adam.
So, everything I've used today, all these billions of things that are on my desk, will be listed below. I'm sure Adam's really going to enjoy doing that. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye! Can I say cocoa pop?
You know I hate that.
Cocoa pop.
I hate it. Don't eat it.